Hi guys and welcome back to some more Oxygen Not Included. My name is Luma and today we're going to build whatever that future me is putting on the screen right now. Hi everyone, future me here. Today we are going to build a infinite gas storage as well as a purification setup. We got lucky enough to get some Paku, so we will be building a Paku breeder as well as a hatch farm to get some stone hatchling eggs. In addition to that, we will be building some infinite liquid storages with a mechanical filter setup on top. We are going to start the episode by checking what we got as printables. At this moment we have the choice between some omelets and the Joya seeds, and because I don't want the duplicates to get too spoiled, we're going to take the Joya seeds. Back in episode 2 we built this filtration room, which takes care of all the dupe pee and gets filtered to clean water. But the clean water is full of germs, and now I think of taking away these germs by running this water through a chlorine room. I will be using the purification room version from my shorts. So, if you are interested in that, go and click on the link in the top right corner. For the purification room, we will need about 4x4 tiles. And because we need to fill it with chlorine, I think we can take the chlorine from this room. Or, I've seen some chlorine up here and some chlorine down here. But I guess this is way too hot. So, our placement will be right here and the chlorine will come from there. First we're going to get rid of everything that is in this room. I'm placing a catching order on him and he will get transported to the critter drop-off that are placed right next to our printing pot. As you can see, I'm building some more storage unit in our power shaft, so all this clutter can get stored there. Now that the space is cleaned out, we are going to fill it with some sandstone tiles and then remove them later so we have a vacuum. As you can see, I've cleared out an area for our liquid lock, and now I'm going to click on the bottle emptier and set the liquid to water and enable auto bottle and wait for it to get filled. While the liquid lock is getting filled, we're going to research for the pathogen diagnostics so we can get the germ sensor for the filtration room. The liquid lock is full enough now, but you can see there's a little bit of carbon dioxide trapped in here. So we have to build another tile to delete the carbon dioxide, and we have a clean slate. Now we have to deconstruct the tile again, and the water will flow to the right, and we have a beautiful water lock. The next task for the duplicates will be to remove the tiles so we have enough space to build our inside of the purification room. By the way, it would have been smarter to build a room out of insulation. Further research is needed. We need the generic sensors, especially the NOT gate, to build our purification room. For our purification room, we will need a pure chlorine atmosphere. So we are going to filter out all other gases, and we're doing that by building a mechanical filter. The mechanical filter, which we are going to build right now, will only let the chlorine gas in this room. First off, we are going to need a gas valve and some gas pipes. And since the gas in this loop will always flow from the green to the white, the gas in this pipe sections will flow upwards. So our input from our gas that we want to filter will come from down to up. Then we're going to bridge it over, and every gas that we don't want can be dumped down here. And the gases that we want will come out of this white section. So this white section will get bridged over and dumped in this room. The gas that we are going to filter will come from the left, and the pump will be placed in there so we can get the chlorine from this room into our filter and only let the clean chlorine in our purification room. To make use of our mechanical gas filter, we first need to prime it with some chlorine, and the chlorine will cycle in here and only let chlorine into this loop. Therefore, we need our gas valve set to a tiny amount. I'm using 0.1 grams a second. I also noticed that this is hydrogen next to the chlorine, and we don't want to dump the hydrogen down there. So I'm going to reroute this to an infinite gas storage, which we can use later. As you can see, this is the setup for now. I rerouted our gas outlet. This will be filled with 1 kg of water. There is the gas pump for later use. I'm putting an automatic cable right next to it, and I need the ladder to get to our purification room. After this is filled, I will close this off so we can have a safe room for later use. If you're planning to store a hot gas, it would be a good idea to build a room out of insulation and a gas pump out of gold amalgam. I've added an automation cable as well as a signal switch and a cable. Now we just have to wait for the bottle emptier to be filled with some water bottles and immediately stop them from dropping more water than we need to. So let's see how this goes. In case it is not blatantly obvious, never use polluted water in your infinite gas storage, because it will off-gas and you will have polluted oxygen in your storage room. As you can see, there's a little bit too much water in there. We want less than 2 kg of water for all the tiles combined. Also, as you can see, there's some carbon dioxide in it. So we're going to deconstruct this tile, replace it with a sandstone tile, then deconstruct this tile, let the water flow out, replace the tile so that the water amount inside is correct. If you want to know how much liquid you need for the infinite gas storage to work properly, you need to divide 2 kg by the room width. Normally, any value below 2 kg would be fine, but since the water stacks when it gets pushed by the gases to the left or to the right, there are times where the gas outlet is still overpressured. Also, there needs to be more liquid than 0.07 kg. After the duplicants finished the job, I placed another gas pipe, as you can see here, and an outlet, so we can remove all of the oxygen and carbon dioxide that has accumulated there after we place the sandstone tiles to close off the room. After that has been taken care of, we can vacuum out that room now. Here are some more infinite gas storage tips. Don't use mixed gases, because it can lead to problems and delete your water, meaning your storage not working anymore. The game was so generous to give us another care package, so we're going to take the snazzy suit. Let's see which dupe deserves the snazzy suit. I think about Ape, because he was with us for a long time and he's one of the happiest dupes, and he can spread his happiness with wearing a beautiful sweater. More ranching for Mima. And a fancier hat. Hey guys, now that we prepared our chlorine room, we need to fill it with some chlorine. To get this, we need to dig through that wall and deconstruct some insulation tile. And also, it would be good to have a liquid lock so the chlorine doesn't flow in our base. For that, I'm going to deconstruct these two tiles and dig straight down. Also, we're going to remove those 3 sand tiles. These sand tiles will fall down, and I think a liquid lock will form there. If some water flows over into our base, we can just mop it up when it runs down these stairs. Editing me here, this crude oil could come in handy later in the game. Since that worked out perfectly, we're going to place our gas pump right there, connect it up to our pipe system, and place some wires so it gets power. It is a good idea to keep in mind that the power shaft will heat up in the future because of the power transformators. As you will see now, our mechanical filter will get primed by the chlorine. So let's see how this goes. Everything that is chlorine should end up in this room, and everything that is not chlorine should end up in this room. So the loop got primed, and every excess chlorine gets sent up here, bridged over, sent down, and ends up in our purification room. Just as intended. In case you were wondering, we only need a couple hundred grams, or even just a few grams, in here to clean out our water. But I want to store some slime and some polluted stuff with germs there, and since I don't want it to off-gas, we need more than 1800 grams of pressure in there. So we're going to fill it up until this gas vent gets overpressured, so every tile in this room has more than or exactly 2 kg of chlorine, and then everything we put in there can't off-gas anymore. I stopped the game right there before the chlorine could end up in our infinite gas storage, because I don't want it there. So I'm going to cut the cable for our gas pump, deconstruct it on some tiles, and see if the dupes are quick enough to shut it down. The duplicants were fast enough, so let's see. No chlorine in our infinite storage. Great. and more than 2 kg of gas in each tile, which is brilliant. How about some electrolyzer research called air systems? We got 3 more skill points, one for Harold, Marie and Trovaldo. And because every one of them needs to wear an exosuit somewhere in the future, we're going to put it in improved carrying. Also, they won't take so long carrying stuff around the base. As you can see, I built the rest of our purification room from my short video, but as many of you may have already noticed, we need plastic, fucking plastic, for our germ sensor. So I think that I'm just gonna hook it up to a signal switch, which I'm going to activate manual when all the water is free of germs, so we can put it right back into our water reservoir until we get some plastic. Here's some information on the purification room. This room isn't designed to handle a non-stop flow of germy water, but it can without a problem handle small amounts from the bathroom setups. The room is finally done and I'm replacing the germ sensor with a signal switch so I can activate it manually. As far as the high threshold and the low threshold goes, I'm testing that out as we are building this. First off, I have to hook up the liquid pipe to our old reservoir so it can rotate the water until it is clean, and I activate the switch, which is not built now, and I can recycle the water back to our liquid pool. Let's see how quickly our duplicants will build those pipes. I had to press stop there because I didn't deactivate the signal switch, so all the water would have run into our liquid pool, which is not what we want right now. In case you were wondering, since we didn't set the threshold of this, this reservoir would fill up all the way, but we don't have a full reservoir here, so it only will take in all the water that has been in this reservoir. It will be full of germs and recycled until it is clean, then we can reuse it. Bert, why the fuck are you sleeping on the floor? Since we are going to need the atmosuit dock sooner or later, I'm going to research it right now so we don't have some idle dupes. The improved ventilation and the textile production will be needed for that, so they will be researched as well. As much as I would love to take in bubbles, I think it's not a good idea to take in more dupes right now. I'm going to insulate some more parts of the base. Hey guys, as I was watching the room overlay, I had an idea. We have only 34 tiles here and 74 tiles here, so if we dig down right there, we will have a nature reserve in this room, which is brilliant and I love it. Man, that took a while. But now we're finished and we have a nature reserve and our insulation tiles to prevent us from some heat transfer. And I think it's a good idea that we have a nature reserve right here. Even more skills for Abe. Let's put him into improved carrying. Now that we have our beautiful purification room, we can transfer all our germy stuff from this room, which is filled with slime lung and also with food poisoning, down to our purification room. For that, I rearranged some tiles, deleted some, built some, placed a wash basin which has to still be delivered with water, and then I'm going to place a storage bin right here. The duplicants will deliver the polluted stuff and the slime lung stuff right there. Then we can deconstruct it or just let the chlorine handle the germs, and when the duplicants run out, they will have to wash their hands and they are germ free. Since the water was stopping in our liquid reservoir, I had to reset the high threshold to a lower value so that the water cycles around a couple of times, because there was still food poisoning in the liquid pipes, even though the liquid reservoir was free of food poisoning. So we just have to wait until this reaches zero, then we can activate our signal switch and dump all of the cleaned water back into our pool. In case you were wondering what I was talking about, the chlorine only cleans the germs from the water if the water is in a liquid reservoir, not the pipes. Since the nearly 2 tons of water are clear now, we are going to flip the switch and dump it in our water and check for the germ overlay. No germs so far, except for this tiny bit of polluted oxygen with slime lung, which I don't know where it came from. Maybe from these slots. Oh yeah, that could be. Let's place some tiles over it. I don't like this. And here, same problem. What do you think how the duplicants would feel if we tell them that we prefer the fungal spore over them? More skills for Bert. And some more research. The chlorine room has a storage bin now, and it is set to priority 9 and slime and polluted dirt. So since the priority is higher than any other storage bin, they will collect the polluted dirt and slime all over the base, especially in our filtration room, and place it in our chlorine room. Now that this has been taken care of, we can pretty up the room a little bit. In a future episode we could fill this room with chlorine, but we need enough chlorine so we have more than 2 kilograms a tile. The reason for that is if we dump some polluted water, it won't off-gas. I've just noticed, if we sweep up this water, it probably will have some germs in it. So I'm going to deactivate water for a short time on all of the dumping places and just activate water in our filtration room. Now we can safely remove this pesky slime lung. After the duplicants pick up the slime, they will carry it to our purification room, where the slime lung is killed over a period of time. The airflow in our water basin could be a little bit better, so I'm placing 2 of these airflow tiles right there, after closing it off with some more sandstone tiles. The reason I was building these 2 tiles was I wanted to be really sure that the water don't escape our water reservoir. Sooner than later we will need some cooling, so I'm going to research for the liquid tuning, especially the thermo aqua tuner. I replaced all the doors in our power shaft with some pneumatic doors, which have a better airflow than the airtight mechanical doors. Also, I connected up our park right here. It's a great time to expand the base. Therefore, we have to dig up 2 plants in our nature reserve. It will still count as one because it only needs 4 plants and we have 10 in it right now. And then we can expand our ladder system upwards. Also, I think I'm going to place one of those sliding poles down here. As you can see, I placed a layout for the digging commands, as well as more insulation to keep the heat from seeping into our base. We just have to wait for the duplicates to build that ladder, then they will dig up and we get more material for the future. While the duplicates are still busy digging, you could do me a favor and comment down below what you want to see in the next episode, whether it is more contraptions or spoiling the duplicates. Hey guys, we got a new care package, but I'm not sure who to take because we got Joshua, who has an amazing skill in suit wearing and +9 athletics, and we got some Mirthleaf. I've decided to take in Joshua and make him our machine guy, so he can build all the auto sweepers and the railings. Therefore, we have to train him up and give him some new priorities and a new schedule. For now, Joshua will be our sweeper and he will be sweeping up all the stuff that is lying down here. But we have to set it to a low priority so the other dupes don't care about this. I had to replace the floor here because our nature reserve got too big and didn't count as one anymore. So it just replaced these 4 tiles and we got our room back. It almost took another cycle until the duplicants were finished expanding the base upwards, as well as constructing the rest of the insulation tiles. Here we go and give Joshua his mess table so he can eat with the others and don't have to eat somewhere alone. Well, look at Mary. Mary seems to be a Sparkle Streaker. The morale bonus of the Sparkle Streaker is put up on the screen right now. Some more research for the radiant gas pipes. Also, skills for Mima and Joshua. Mima will be our art decorator and Joshua has to be our tinkerer, so he can become a mechatronics engineer. We can start with carrying. I place a fire pole on our central ladder segment, so the duplicants will have a shorter travel time. More research for the advanced automation. Hey guys, I just had an idea to make this free space to a stable. We have a 85 tiles big room, which means 84 tiles equals 7 critters, so we could have 7 hatches inside of here. So I set the critter drop off to 6, so it doesn't get overcrowded as fast, set it to hatch and hatchlings, as well as the critter feeder to sedimentary rock. Because if the hatches eat sedimentary rock for a longer time, they are more capable of laying eggs 4 stone hatchlings, and stone hatchlings can eat igneous rock, and we have a lot of igneous rock. I set the priorities to 7, so Mima, who is our rancher, will do this faster than other tasks. Also, we will have to keep an eye on sedimentary rock, which we only had 1 ton of it, and now we have to look for more, which we can do by the material overlay, and we are looking for minerals. Sedimentary rock is blue, and I already scouted out a big vein, and we are going to dig this one up. While we are at it, why not take the gold amalgam too, and sweep it up right here. We cleaned out the room and resealed it again. Care packages are available. Yes, Paku! Nice! So, in case you were wondering why I put this water pool right next to our printing port or underneath it, we can close off this door or build a tile here, and the Paku will, sooner or later, fall down where we want them to. I will be doing that right now by placing a block here. Now that we placed the block here, we can release our Paku. They will flop around until they hit the edge, fall down, and land in our water pool. There we go. This could take a while. Right now I'm going to build a fish feeder and kill off all the Paku that aren't needed. Each Paku needs 8 tiles of water. Right now we have 33 tiles, that means 32 divided by 8, we can have 4 Paku in here. After gruesomely murdering all the Paku, the remaining Paku will eat some algae until they are tame. When they are tamed, this takes around 10 cycles, they will lay eggs every couple of cycles, and we will be using these eggs to start our Paku farm. Harold will be a better carrier, and Mary will be the same thing. What I'm planning for the future is using these Paku as breeder Pakus, so they lay a lot of Paku eggs, and we transport those eggs to some other spot where they can hatch, lay one egg in their lifetime, die out, and leave some Paku filet. So it's a self-sustaining living and death circle for the Pakus in the future. To build a Paku farm, we will need the access to the auto sweeper and to some solid transport, especially the conveyor loader. Because I want to expand the base further upwards in the next episodes, I'm going to need to get rid of the polluted water in these pockets. But because it takes up a lot of space to store, we are just going to put it in an infinite storage down here. I decided that if we are already at it building some infinite storages, we are going to build 3. One for polluted water, one for water, and one for everything else that could end up in our filter system, so it doesn't ruin our storages. Future me here, there are some small mistakes in this build right now, but you will see me correct them. What did I tell you about dupes getting trapped? Here we are at it again. Come on, save the dupes! It wasn't a close call, but we managed to save them. We got more printables, and look at this. 12,000 calories of barbecue, awesome. I'm going to take this, print it, and we're going to save it in our ration box. We just have to think about if we want the duplicants to actually eat it or not. We can save it up for bedtime when their moral is low, and then we can allow it, because it gives +8 moral. I thought about it and I think they can eat all the barbecue, because they will get overjoyed and work faster. We got 4 more skill points, one for Abe, one for Bert, Joshua and Trovaldo. Joshua will be our mechatronics engineer, so he will get improved carrying. Trovaldo needs to wear an exosuit sooner or later, so he has to get the rocket piloting skill. And Bert, same thing, exosuit training for the future, as well as Abe. Abe gets the improved construction trait. Now that the room for the infinite storage is built, we're going to place the liquid pump in there, and I'm going to use a gold amalgam liquid pump because it can take in more heat before it gets destroyed or broken. Here you can see Sparkle Streaker Mary in her natural habitat. After that, we will be needing some wires which I placed right here, and another of these transformers, and we are going to dig down on our power shaft. If we ever need to access the water that is stored in there, we need to activate a pump. Therefore, I placed a signal switch and a cable right here. Also, I made a big mistake. These tiles have to be full tiles, no airflow tiles, so that here will be a gas tile, here will be another full tile, and all the other tiles will be water or other liquids, so that our infinite storage works. Because otherwise I would have to use crude oil and do it the other way around, the liquid vent on the bottom, crude oil on top, and then the liquid. Because I did not pay enough attention to our hatches, the room is overcrowded now, because we got 5 hatches and 3 eggs, so we have to get rid of the eggs, that the room isn't overcrowded anymore and they start reproducing again. For now I placed all the eggs in our nature reserve. As you can see, we have 3 hatchling eggs and another 2 hatchling eggs, as well as a sage hatchling egg. If we are storing our eggs too long in such a bin, they will break and turn into a raw egg. So we have to decide what we are going to do with them fairly quickly. This is how the finished version of our infinite liquid storage looks. As you can see, this is our power setup, our liquid setup, our automation setup, and the most important part, here is some gas in this tile. Now all we have to do is build some filtration systems. As you should know by now, we need a liquid well for that, some pipes. It works the same way as for the gas wells. It flows from green to white, therefore it flows in this direction, and our input water pipe will come from down below, from this direction. Now we have to bridge over. And everything that we filtered will come from this white part. And everything that we don't want will keep running in this pipe. So maybe I have to add a storage for whatever comes out of this pipe that isn't filtered in our filter systems. After that, we have to prime our filter loops, once with water, once with polluted water, and once with whatever comes up. After that, we have to set the filter to a very low value. Let's try 0.1. 0.1 works, copy it over, done. Turning off all those pumps and taking in more algae. To safely get rid of all the oxygen, I built a little setup right here. We are going to dig in this wall, as well as here, and upwards. Then the water will be collected in our setup for the liquid pump, pumped through the base. This will give off a little heat, but I think that's okay. Right through this liquid shutoff, which is on a timer, so it shuts off every couple hundred of seconds, so that we don't have a continuous stream of water. The polluted water will prime this liquid loop and be filtered into our infinite liquid storage. Every other liquid that comes through will be primed the next loop, and everything that isn't filtered right here will be dropped through this liquid vent. Let's see how this goes. Speed up the game a little bit. First, the duplicants will dig through the mineral tiles. Then the polluted water will get sucked up by the pump and transported down to our filter system. On its way to the storage, the water crosses our liquid shutoff, it gets halted for a couple of seconds and then sent to our liquid loops. The liquid loop will get filled to the set value and the rest of the water will get dropped. More coal for the generators. Here's a quick comparison of the amount of water our infinite storage can take. Hey everyone, since I need the rest of the time editing this, we are going to do recap right now. Today we built a water purification room, which needs to be activated manually, but we can automate it in the future when we get a germ sensor. We also have the mechanical gas filter, which filters out our chlorine in case we need more of it. We started a small hatch ranch and we already got our first stone hatchling egg. So we can start up our stone hatchling farm in the next episode. We got really lucky in terms of we got some Paco from the printing pot, which are already tamed, and laid an egg. So we can build our Paco farm in the next episode. Craft is looking more and more legit, as well as we broke through the wall to another biome. We built an infinite liquid storage for 3 different liquids. Now we are pumping in polluted water, which comes from our expansion on the top of the base. Here you can see we expanded quite a lot, And we're pumping off the water from these different polluted water pools. And when it is emptied out, we can dig upwards. I wish you all a fantastic day and I hope to see you in the next one. Love you and Luma out.